Success starts with self-discipline. And that is the thought for today. Welcome to 7 Good Minutes. I'm Clyde Lee Dennis. Thanks for joining me for what I believe will be 7 of the most enriching minutes of your day. In today's audio, we get a great message on how to develop your self-discipline. Enjoy.
Today, we're going to learn about 12 tips to build unbreakable self-discipline. Now, let's begin. Number 1, daily rewrites. Self-discipline is a daily war that you wage against yourself. At any moment, a wave of laziness could overwhelm your defenses and destroy your productivity. So, you're constantly in need of motivation and reinforcement to keep yourself disciplined. To make sure you stay strong, you can't rely on a list of goals that you wrote months or even years ago. Not only are they sitting too far back in your memory, but also your goals have probably changed since then, huh? And that's a good thing. You should be adapting your goals as you become more ambitious and productive. Both your wins and your losses should help you refine your unique definition of success. So, to fortify your self-discipline, try to rewrite or re-examine your goals every single day. You could do it first thing in the morning or right before bed. Either way, it's important that you're consistently reminding yourself why your success matters, why you're investing so much time and effort to achieve your dreams. Those reminders will help you power through the rough patches and stay focused when temptation tries to lead you astray. Number 2, technological shortcuts. When it comes to self-discipline, technology is often framed as the root of all evil. It can completely ruin your workflow. And if you're not careful, it will waste hours of your time. It's so easy to access the internet, social media, and online games that most people avoid technology as much as possible. It's just too tempting. But technology can also be an extremely helpful tool for developing your self-discipline. For example, some applications track changes in your daily routines. It can tell you detailed information about your diet, your exercise, and sleep schedule that you would never know otherwise. But these applications are only useful if you input information every day. That way, you can understand trends in your behavior over long periods of time. Now, don't be afraid to pick up one of these tracking apps and incorporate it into your routine. Just make sure you don't get too, distracted, right? Number 3, raw diet. A healthy diet can improve everything from how well you concentrate to the quality of your work. You need enough proteins and carbohydrates to give you energy, enough vitamins to grow and develop, not to mention plenty of water to protect your organs and regulate your body temperature. Now, with all that in mind, what foods lend themselves to a more disciplined lifestyle? Well, there's one particular type of food that's especially useful for staying motivated. Unprocessed fruits, vegetables, nuts, and other raw foods are fantastic sources of energy. That's because it takes very little effort for your body to digest food when it's eaten raw. This difference between energy consumed and energy used is called dietary-induced thermogenesis, or DIT. Now, a study from 2004 found that people with low DIT values tend to struggle with obesity and other health issues. Because they have less energy to spare, people with low DIT may struggle to be productive, overcome obstacles, and avoid laziness. By consuming more raw foods, you can raise your DIT and supply your body with more than enough energy to stay disciplined throughout the day. And of course, remember to always consult a medical professional before beginning any diet or exercise routine to make sure it's right for you. Number 4, productive pairing. Every day you face two kinds of tasks. First are the things you want to do. These activities are fun, positive, and usually don't require much effort. On the other hand, there are things you should do. As productive as they are, these jobs aren't always a walk in the park. So how do you stay productive without missing out on the things that you enjoy? Try pairing them together. Combine your should-dos with your want-tos. If, for example, If you should be drinking a kale smoothie for breakfast, blah, watch an episode of your favorite show while you do it. This combination is so effective because it rewards you for doing something you don't like. You're much more likely to repeat a healthy behavior if you didn't completely hate it the first time around. Number 5. Deciding the difference. Do you ever look back at the day and think about all the things you could have done differently? You could have worked harder, eaten better, or taken more risks. You could have saved yourself from an embarrassing moment or avoided a run-in with failure. When you're trapped in a vortex of what-ifs, your fears and anxiety often take over. You start feeling sad and stressed out because you can't get those mistakes out of your head. This can be devastating for your productivity. The last thing you want is to lose faith in yourself. So, instead of listing out everything you did wrong, just pick one thing that you want to change. Just one thing that you believe would have made a real difference in your day. And when you've done that, start planning out how you can make that change tomorrow. So while no one can turn back time, there will always be opportunities to redeem yourself, no matter how bad you mess up. Number 6. Know your nature. Everyone works best at different times. Some people are filled with energy in the mornings. Others kick things into high gear when the sun goes down. It really doesn't matter which kind of worker you are, as long as you aren't fighting your natural rhythm. In other words, if you know you work better at night, then don't squeeze all your work into the morning. You'll feel worse, you'll work slower, and you'll have a harder time staying focused. It may take a bit of trial and error to decide what time of day works best for you, but once you figure that out, you can use your biological clock to your advantage.
Please keep in mind, this is about half of the entire presentation. If you're up for a treat, you should definitely listen to the whole thing. You can do so by clicking the link labeled View the Full Video on YouTube in the show notes. So that does it for this episode of 7 Good Minutes. Until next time, let's be civil to one another out there. Thanks for listening.